Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Todoist series. My name is Carl Pullein, and this week I'm going to show you how you can use Todoist to manage a team of people. Now, Todoist has amazing collaborative tools that you can use to manage a team. Now, for those of you using the time sector system, when you couple the time sector system to Todoist collaboration tools, you have a very, very powerful tool to manage your team. And because of 2020 changing the way we work, and many of you out there working remotely, so you're trying to manage a team in a remote setting, these tools are incredibly powerful. So before we go into my Todoist and show you how to set this up, what I would just like to say is if you do get any value from this episode, now please hit that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you would like to get all the latest news, tips and tricks on using Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me now take you into my Todoist and I will show you how to set it up so that you can manage a team of people. Okay, so what we're going to do here is, first of all, we're going to set my this week project up for sharing. Now, this, if you are a leader in a team, this is basically how I would recommend that you do it. Now, of course, you could also share next week and this month if you wish, but the number one important project to be sharing on a weekly basis is your this week folder. So to share a folder, all you have to do is go to the three dots at the side right here, and you're going to see share project. So you hit that and you can type in the email address of the person that you want to share. So I'm going to share it with my main account. I'm going to invite that. Now this is showing pending because I need to accept that. So I'm just going to go to my iPad. You can't see me do this, but I'm just going to accept that. And I need to go into my Todoist. So let me just go into Todoist and I'm going to close that. And I will accept this right now. So you'll see in a moment, that's now accepted, done. And I can come out of that. And what you'll see now is that this icon here has changed to the site of a person icon. So now this whole project is now available for sharing. So I can now go through this list. So if I was the team leader, for example, I can go through this list on Monday morning or Sunday night, and I can go into here and I can actually assign a person, which is this icon here. So I'm going to assign that. So this indicates who I am. I have no friends, by the way, which is why I have to use myself. I'm going to assign that to the other Carl, if you like. And we've got another one for Cronstein, so we can get Carl to do that one. And I will do that, so I can assign that to myself. And arrange for helicopter, I will get the other Carl to do that. And I'll book Blofeld's cat in for its wash and cut, so I'll give that to me. So essentially that's how you do, and you start the week off and you just assign this to your team members, which is a really cool way of doing it. Now the other thing is, I've done this one, so I'm going to arrange this. We've arranged for Carl. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a note in here and say this is urgent and needs doing by close of business on Thursday. So I'm going to add that. So that comment has been added by me, and what I'm going to do now is, if I go into the project on my iPad again, so we've got a note here. I can see the notes there. And I will say, my other Carl is going to reply to that and say, okay, I'm on it, and send that. So that's now gone off. And it just takes a few minutes, but it will come in. It will, promise you, it will come in. It does take a few minutes. There you go. That's a few minutes, actually a few seconds, really, maybe about 45 seconds. And that comes in. Now, the other thing is if Carl then actually does that, and so he's arranging the helicopter, and if Carl actually does that and checks that off, so that's now been checked off. I'm going to just come out of that. And you'll see that this will ultimately disappear. And as you can see, it's gone. Now, the thing is, what you're wondering is, oh, now I don't know what's been done. Well, actually, you do, because you can go into this section here. And now you can see that Carl's completed a task in this week, which is what? Arranged for helicopter to do it on Tuesday. Carl added a comment. Okay, I'm on it. And Carl joined this week. So you've got a lot of actual controls right from this window here, this alert window. Now, I can mark them all as red, and they're now all red. So that's one way that you can actually manage projects. And you can add as many people to this as you possibly can. So if you're in a team and you're a team leader, Todoist will enable you to be able to allocate work within your team, and you don't have to be emailing them or calling them or using Slack messages or Microsoft Teams just to see what's going on. Right from the Todoist window, you can see what your team is actually doing. Now, another thing that you can do is right up here. Now, this is something that I considered the other day, is if you're actually working within a team, you can actually use sections. So let's just go down here, and I'm going to create a section for Peter. So I can do Peter. I can also add a section for Jane. So those sections now are added. So what I will do then is I've got, okay, this is a task for Peter, so I'm going to drop that in there. This is a task for Jane, and I'm going to drop that one in there. I'm going to ask Jane to do that one, so I can just drop that in there. Oops, and just pull that one out. So what you can do is you can allocate work. Now, if I share this project, which I can do right there, this means that Jane can easily see the work that she has to do because I've set it up as sections. So that's another really, really easy way that you can set organize work within a team. And then you can actually see how your team is doing right from the sections within a project. So there you go. There's just some of the things that you can do if you really want to use Todoist in order to manage your team's work. I think it's a really, really good way. I mean, I don't actually have a team to be able to practice this with. I wish I did, but I can see how this would benefit so many people. And some of my clients, some of the companies that I'm actually working with, this is an area that we've been working on over the last few months since we've gone into a lot of remote working. This is one of the ways that you can actually manage your team. And it's worked really well with the people that I've actually worked on with them. So hopefully this has given you some ideas with if you're working within a team. And even if you're not a team leader, maybe you can actually suggest this to your boss and to see if you can encourage people to do it. Now, the way that this works is ideally all of you would need to be on at least the pro account or at least the team's account. A business account. The only thing is that as long as one of you is actually a prime premium user, then you can still allocate tasks to non-premium user people. Just that they're not going to have the same functionality, and I'm not entirely sure that they can respond to messages like that. I think they possibly can. But as long as one of you, and that presumably is you, has the premium account, then this actually works really well, even with people who don't have the premium account and just use the free account. So there you go. Well, thank you very much for watching this episode. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Well, thank you very much for watching this video. Now, I'd like to introduce you to a brand new way of managing your tasks. Now, this system is called the Time Sector System. It's designed to do away with your projects, to do away with your goals, or at least do away with them from your time management system, your to-do list manager, and instead focuses on when you are going to do the task. Now, the reason for this is from a research that I did for the whole of last year, figuring out why most people were really struggling with their tasks, getting their tasks done on a day-to-day basis. What I discovered was they were managing their tasks by project. And the biggest problem with managing tasks by project is, first of all, deciding whether a task is a project or not. Two or more tasks becomes a project, which means that you end up with a huge project list. And once you have a huge project list, just managing that list takes up an awesome amount of time. Time you could well better be spent actually doing the work, not organizing. The time sector method is designed to do away with all that processing so that the only decision you have to make is when are you going to do a task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired how urgent a task is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. So the whole clip, this I have launched a brand new course that gives you the step-by-step approach of setting up the time sector method. It's a revolutionary course. It's designed for the 21st century. For all the inputs that we get today, all the emails, the Slack messages, and everything else that comes our way, it's designed to deal with that, to manage that, so you stay focused on what you have identified are your most important tasks for the day. I'd love to see you in the course. Full details of the course are in the show notes below. I'd love you to check it out. Join me in the course and let's take your productivity to a greater level than you've ever, ever imagined. Well, thank you very much for watching this video. I just wish you all a very, very productive week.